Welcome to the Culinary Institute of America. This is our first virtual open house with the Singapore Institute of Technology. My name is Eve Felder, and I'm Managing Director of CIA Singapore. Today, we're going to introduce you to the large CIA. We'll start out first with a video which highlights our main campus in Hyde Park, New York. Then we'll talk about specifically CIA Singapore and our education here. And then we have the opportunity for three alumni of CIA Singapore to speak to you about their educational journey as well as their career paths. So we're going to start out first with the video, and here we go. For the CIA, food is life. Food is at the center of everyone's life. Over 100% of people must eat. So having a deep, hands-on understanding of food and the business of food gives you unlimited career opportunities. In fact, you can change the world with food. It is expected that within the next decade, we will have 1.6 million food industry jobs. Today, food industry has a wide variety of opportunities beyond the restaurant. You can definitely become a successful chef or pastry chef, and the CIA will provide you with over 1,300 hours of experiential learning in our kitchens, bake shops, and restaurant. With that skill set, you can use it into many different career opportunities, such as beverage management, food policy, and research and development. Preparing you for a life, the CIA has four campuses. However, we share one mission, and that mission is to provide the world's best professional culinary education and prepare you for a successful career in food and hospitality. We deliver on that mission in all four campuses, and here you'll see in the center Hyde Park, New York. You'll see Greystone, our campus in the Napa Valley. We actually have two campuses in the Napa Valley, Greystone and Copia. In the center is San Antonio, Texas. And finally, we have our first international campus in Singapore, CIA Singapore. The CIA offers four bachelor's degrees. In Singapore, we have the Bachelor's of Business Administration in Food Business Management. In addition, the CIA has master's degrees in food business and wine management. Our curriculum is based on experiential learning. As I said, over 1,300 hours of hands-on experience in our classrooms, in our bake shops, and in our restaurant. In addition, we have our travel abroad program, where our students from Singapore travel to Northern California and study food, wine, and agriculture. I hope you'll enjoy this video of their experience in Northern California.
I know a place where we can head up there, sail on a sunset to the sky. Wave to the people, everyone you know, up on a satellite. Cause we go, watching cities and streets come to life. Yeah, you know, we're just starting, we're learning to fly. Head for the stars, here we are, living like creatures of the night. Never grow old, stay young in our soul, we can outrun the day. Shadows, you know the story's just begun. Rocking the blue jeans, jamming to Springsteen. Baby, we're born to run. Cause we go, watching cities and streets come to life. Yeah, you know, we're just starting, we're learning to fly. Head for the stars, here we are, living like creatures of the night. Never grow.
The next experiential learning is our internships. We have over 2,000 approved sites for you to do your work placement, and these are paid. Plus, most importantly, they are a graduation requirement. So it is up to us to make sure that you have the best placement for you. Over 70% of our students from Singapore travel internationally to do their externships. And when you're looking for a college that you want to go to, you need to think about the quality of the faculty. We have over 150 expert chefs and instructors from 19 different countries on all four of our campuses. They're anthropologists, authors, bakers, chemists, historians, marketers, nutritionists, and wine experts. We have over 50,000 alumni. Again, this is something when you're considering a university, you consider who are their alumni? Because the truth be told, alumni hire alumni. These are some examples of where our alumni are and who they are, and I'm sure you will recognize many of them. They have made a difference in the world of food. Coming to the CIA is actually an investment for your life. You not only start out with an extraordinary skill set, but you can build your career into huge and many different opportunities. For the bachelor's degree in food business management at CIA Singapore, it is a 130-credit degree program, and it is divided into four pillars: business management, leadership development, skills-based classes, and those are the 1,300 hours that are a progressive learning year, meaning that you will be exposed to skills at point A, point B, you'll build on those skills, repeat those skills, and then point C, again, repeat those skills and build again until you have a toolbox full of skills that you can launch your career. We also, the fourth pillar is liberal arts, and in Singapore, people may not be so familiar with liberal arts, but actually this is a study of history, of culture, of languages, of literature. You will ultimately lead this industry, so your confidence in knowing about the globe is very, very important. There are two tracks: culinary arts, where we accept 42 students, and baking and pastry arts, where we accept 16 students. So SIT will accept your applications. The date opens today. They'll also provide you with scholarship opportunities. As Duff Goldman says, when you leave here, you'll have a piece of paper that says you're a graduate of the Culinary Institute of America. That paper is a passport. With it, you can go anywhere, eat anywhere, and work anywhere. So please, if you're interested in the CIA, apply today. Now I would like to introduce you to our alumni. We'll start out first with Chef Elaine Koh, followed by Gerard Yip, and then Hadi Mohammed. Chef Elaine.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Elaine, and I was part of the Pioneer Batch in CIA Singapore. So before I even joined the school, I found my passion back when I was in poly doing my diploma, when I was studying hospitality and tourism. So upon graduation, I knew that this was what I wanted to do with my life. I wanted to go into culinary school. I wanted to be in the professional kitchen. So upon graduation, I looked around for a school, first locally. However, since I already have a diploma, I did not want to take my second diploma again. So if I wanted to have a higher education, I have to look internationally. And that was when I chanced upon Culinary Institute of America. The thing about that is the tuition fees are through the roof. And fortunately for me, CIA, instead of me going over to them in the States, they came to me in Singapore through Singapore Institute of Technology, and I'm very, very thankful for that because tuition fees are much more affordable now. And as the pioneer batch in the Culinary Institute of America, I learned so much. It was I stepped in a whole new world full of exciting modules that is not just kitchen-based, as Chef Felder had already explained. I particularly enjoyed being in the liberal arts courses, taking classes such as History of Europe, so many exciting things about that. Taking French, very useful when you're working in a French kitchen. And also, not just that, taking psychology and nutrition, so it really gives us a better world perspective and, you know, a better foundation to just life in general. So after graduation, there were so many career opportunities available to me. And I've decided since the beginning, right, I wanted to be in a professional kitchen. I've been making strategic decisions to where I want to work with and work in a competitive environment. and I also focused on the cuisine that I'm most interested in, which was French fine dining. So one of the first few restaurants that I was at Jeanne, where I was part of a team that clinched a spot on the inaugural San Pellegrino Asia 50 Best list, and they have been on the list ever since then. Moving on from there, I think I was most proud to be part of the opening team at Odette, which is currently Singapore's best restaurant, and not just that, I think it's also Asia's best restaurant as well. They garnered so many accolades, and during my time there, we got 2 Michelin stars. And nothing quite beats the adrenaline of opening a new restaurant, being part of a team, working for a world-renowned chef, and the next challenge was moving away from the comfort of what French fine dining has given to me by going to a higher volume concept, and that was with Chef Jean-Georges Von Gerieten, who has an empire in New York itself and around the world, and he opened at Dempsey Cookhouse and Bar. So I love getting challenged on a daily basis. After a 2-year stint there, the dust have already settled, and I start beginning to think of my next move. So when I got wind that, hey, La Dame de Pique is going to open in Singapore at the newly refurbished Raffles Hotel, I knew that was going to be my next calling. And I paused, and then again I joined them as part of the opening team, back to French fine dining, and into this whole new magical world where I am led by a female authoritarian on food. It was a world of delicate feminine flavors, very vibrant colors on the plate, and super intricate plating. And then from then on, my career has always been about kitchen, working in competitive restaurants, long hours. Never thought that I would make my next move, which was actually really scary, but at the same time, a lot more rewarding and fulfilling than I initially thought it would be. So this my most drastic move was what I'm going to do now. And I'm very honored, humble, and proud to say that I am the first CIA Singapore alumni to be chosen as part of the teaching faculty member in Singapore, and I get to groom the future culinarians at the CIA Singapore itself. So thank you for the opportunity that CIA has given to me, and I'd like to pass my time to the next alumni, Gerald.
Hi, good morning. It's really weird doing this virtually because I'm always doing it with a live audience for so many years. So just let me start my journey with CIA itself. I started in 2012. Back then, I came in as an operations manager, not knowing anything about cooking. So that was why I decided to pursue this degree program, because back then I was managing about 20 over restaurants, different concepts, but I have no way of making sure that my kitchen is running well. So the CIA program is very, very versatile. Having gone through this program itself, the 3 most important components that I would say would be the hands-on practice. That's definitely one thing. The next thing is, of course, the global perspective that you get from learning about the histories and cultures. That really helped me, because in the next role that I was about to do, right, I spent time in the kitchen in Singapore for about 4 years, Japanese fine dining, Chinese fine dining, serving in the F1 Grand Prix itself with the president, Gordon Ramsay. So those were the life that I was getting, but I felt that something was a little bit lacking in that exposure that I have, because it was mainly in Singapore. So I had the opportunity, before joining a regional role, to develop this farm-to-table concept, which you guys might have seen in Tebing Lane. It's actually a first container park farm-to-table concept that was developed. And it was all developed with the skill sets that I acquire through CIA itself. One of the key things about the program itself is it trains you to think before you even do anything. And next thing, the skill sets that you get is definitely transferable. During my time, there was no baking and pastry, but for the 3 months that I learned under one of our most esteemed lecturer, Chef Dieter Schorner, it helped me to manage a franchise network of more than 400 branches. Single-handedly, in 4.5 years, I managed to grow BreadTalk overseas with more than 100 branches from Indonesia all the way to Saudi Arabia. So how did a guy like me who hated baking, that was my worst module that I've gone through, manage to do this? That was because of the rigor and the intensity of the module, and the program itself and definitely the instructors. Time to time, when I need to relook at my career path, I always take up hijack chef in a day and just check with her to see whether my career path is something which is relevant itself. So 4.5 years, I'm literally back in Singapore for not more than 2 weeks before flying off to the next city. That gave me that confidence, because when you troubleshoot and turn around businesses, and when you go into a different, I would say, culture different from Singapore, and you're able to scale and replicate the Singapore concept, that gives you a lot of, I would say, leverage in terms of how you would go on to your next career path itself. So I would like to challenge people who are now wondering whether this program is for you, right? I mean, during COVID, you will realize that many general degree programs are facing a difficulty, retrenchments that's happening, and that's real because I've encountered people around me that were retrenched, right? But I had the option, because of the skill sets and the exposure that I had, to now decide to go away from a regional role due to the COVID crisis and come back home to Singapore again to take on a very exciting career, to relook and revamp the way how people look at traditional fishball noodles. So the versatility of the program is not just in fine dining. That's where I started for, you know. It doesn't just stay there. It helps you to be able to look into a career beyond the kitchen itself. So of course, you need to start with the kitchen. That's how you get the knowledge in order to manage the food business. But at the same time, it grants you that tenacity to be able to make decisions by the millions when you invest in a restaurant, when you select in a restaurant, and when you do network planning. So if you were to think that this role or this program for you is just something that is going to be in the kitchen, you are wrong. Anything in the food and beverage industry is up for you to choose. So with that, I will pass on to Hadi. Thank you.
Thank you, Gerard. It's so good to be here today. And also, thank you, Chef Felder and SIT, for the opportunity to share my story. I've always had the passion for food, the infinite possibilities of bringing together different elements into one dish has always been alluring for me. When I came across the Food Business Management Program offered by the world-famous Culinary Institute of America right here on our local shores, I was overwhelmed because I believed that this would be a perfect flat platform for me to hone my culinary skills and management skills for the future. The Culinary Institute of America have gone on to produce some of the greatest icons and some of the greatest names in the industry. This was my chance to learn what they have learned in the initial stages of my career. I've spent several semesters over the past year focusing on hands-on culinary training, where we are constantly drilled on basic culinary fundamentals, followed by exploring cuisines from a myriad of countries in the Mediterranean, Americas, and Asia. Apart from 1,300 hours spent in the kitchen, we are also exposed to academic modules like French, histories and culture, entrepreneurship, literature, so on and so forth. One of my most memorable experiences I've had was a one-month-long trip to California. Being a local Singaporean boy through and through, I know how much of a food paradise Singapore is. Getting a chance to go abroad, off our shores, to see how others interact with food was so fulfilling for me. The passion and dedication everyone had with their craft was truly admirable. We spent the entire time learning so much about how they interacted with food. Winemakers to farmers to brewers, we spent 30 days in a beautiful place that I'll never forget. During my last semester, I was fortunate enough to be involved in an externship in a Michelin-starred restaurant in San Francisco, California. The experience of working in an entirely different country was truly amazing. It was about getting out of my comfort zone to experience something brand new. Even though it was daunting at first, it was a step that I took that I'll never ever regret. Apart from the technical aspect of cooking and managing a business, the CIA was able to teach me how to become a better version of myself. Above everything, I learned the importance of discipline, self-confidence, and respect for the craft. Thank you.